guys, it's Brandon Miniman from PocketNow.com. We are taking a look at the Droid Bionic by Motorola. It has the Tegra 2 platform, so dual-core 1 gigahertz processors, 4G speeds. The only difference between this and the Atrix is that this has less RAM, 512 megabytes. We think that that's because this device can't do the dock, you know, the dock with the little netbook thing. So let's go to applications and take a look at how much RAM we have available at this moment in time, just to get a sort of confirmation on that. So it's a little bit slow, actually, which is kind of surprising. So we are not in the right screen here. Let's go to running services. And there we get a little look down there how much memory we have. So probably about 300 megabytes of RAM after the operating system takes hold of some. So this is the QHD display, which means that you get an extra amount of pixels down here. It's 960 by 540. And you can really tell, like on the Atrix, you can really tell that to be the case by the home screen, because you get an extra row of icons on the bottom, kind of like a dock. So you can swipe to the right, swipe to the left. Performance seems to be a little bit choppy, which is strange for dual core processors, right? So let's move around here, let's open up a few apps, jump into the web browser here, and see what it's like in there. So if someone was on YouTube, see what video playback looks like here. Lots of fingerprints on the screen.
So, hey, how's it going, everyone? It's all
so yeah, smooth line. Video. You expect that to be the case here. Let's jump into another application. So let's go to, I don't have Quadrant installed on here, unfortunately. We'll go into Google Maps, wherever that might be. I'm having trouble finding Google Maps. It doesn't seem to be installed on here. Okay, we'll go to something else in that case. So let's just jump around Alarm and Timer, just get an idea of the performance again. So, Skype demo. So it's just a video, really. And so again, like we're finding on the Atrix, this device isn't that fast, and maybe it's because the software is not yet optimized to take advantage of the dual-core processor. Look, it's Android 2.2.1, Froyo. Anyhow, that is the Droid Bionic, like the Atrix, but less RAM, and it doesn't have the dock functionality. Overall, a thin device, probably has a pretty big battery to be able to handle that 4G LTE connectivity on Verizon. And there's the power button on the top, and kind of a rubbery feel to the back. You can sort of see that over there. I've got the HDMI over here on the left side of the device, and that's the Droid Bionic. That's it for now.